Hello, this is Ellie from Ipswich County Library, and today I'll be showing you how to make marbled paper. You're going to need acrylic paint that you dilute with a little water. You'll need paint brushes, paint pots to mix these mixtures of acrylic paint and water in. You will also want one of just pure water for cleaning brushes. Two shallow trays, one with water and one with liquid cornstarch, which you can make at home, and it's a very simple recipe. Card or paper to marble, and you'll need things to stir. You're probably going to want to wear old clothes and have an old tablecloth down because acrylic paint will stain. You can flick the diluted acrylic paint from earlier across the top in any kind of pattern. You can use chopsticks to swirl it about, you can try and draw things in it, and then when you put the paper on top and pull it away, you should put it in the shallow tray of water to wash off the excess just for a couple of seconds. So 10 seconds in the first tray to let the paint soak in, 5-10 seconds in the second tray to just wash the excess off, and then you can hang it up to dry. Paper marbling has existed since around 900 Common Era and first began in East Asia before spreading to the Islamic world and then onto Europe. Cool thing about marbling paper is every single piece of marble paper is unique and no two papers are ever the same. Even if you use the same colours, the same tools, and you drop it on as similarly as possible, it will do its own thing once it hits the liquid. You will notice that I have taped some glue spreaders to a ruler, and this was to form an impromptu comb to pull streaks of paint through, because there is a pattern in paper marbling called non-pareil, which forms like little, lots of like little waves, little loops, and that is achieved by pulling something quite similar to a comb through the paint. And so you can see that I gave it a go myself here. Mine didn't work so well because the glue spreaders taped to a ruler made a very wide toothed comb, and so yeah, the effect isn't as effective as I wanted it to be, but it still looks pretty cool. by the end, you will have some really pretty paper that you can do anything with. If you do a big enough sheet, Christmas is coming up, you can use it as wrapping paper, you can use it to make gift tags, to make Christmas cards. One of my colleagues, Joe, is very talented in origami, so he made a little paper crane, so you could use it for that. It's totally up to you what you want to do with it.